Joining us is committee member, Democratic presidential candidate Kamala Harris. Senator Harris, first of all, I know there's only so much you can say, but what can you tell us about the closed door meeting today between your committee and the inspector general and the acting DNI? Were they forthcoming? Did you learn anything new?
Well, you're right, Anderson. I can't talk about what we learned. It was a classified briefing, but I'm happy to tell you it was a bipartisan group of senators, and I expect that there will be more information coming. But, you know, the overall issue, you actually don't necessarily need to be in a skiff to understand. The president told us what he did, and there is a transcript of what he did that was supplied by the White House. And it indicates very clearly that, yet again, Donald Trump is lawless, that he believes he is above the law, and that he can engage in blatant misconduct in the name of the United States of America for personal gain, and he thinks he can get away with it. But I think it's just one time too many. But, you know, the way I think about this, you know, Maya Angelou, the great Maya Angelou, she told us a long time ago, she said, listen to people when they tell you who they are. Listen the first time. What did he tell us when he was running for office? He said, I can stand on Fifth Avenue and shoot somebody and get away with it.
Let me ask just a couple things. The inspector general has done a couple of interviews. I mean, based on that's what the inspector general's job is. Once he got this complaint, and he seemed to, even though he raised questions about, you know, this whistleblower may not like President Trump or may support another candidate, there was enough corroborating information that he received that he felt this was valid and should go to Congress. Is the inspector general's role at this point now done, and is it purely up to Congress to investigate? And how much of an investigation do you want to see? Because I know some folks in Congress are saying, look, this should just be done quickly. It's pretty much all out there. This doesn't need to be a months and months and months long thing.
Well, the process needs to have integrity, but for it to have integrity, it doesn't mean it needs to drag on. It should happen quickly. It should happen swiftly. There is so much about what we need to know that we already know based on the information supplied to us by the White House and told to us by the president. He has engaged in conduct that is, it is in violation of what is his ethical and moral responsibility to the people of the United States of America when he serves as commander in chief, which is that he is not to use that platform and that position in a way that is about self-gain and political gain, especially when talking with the leader of a foreign government and bartering and bargaining and, frankly, holding American and U.S. taxpayer dollars hostage until he gets what he wants politically. So there is so much about what we need to know that we actually know. And of course, the process will take its course. But I don't think that it has to go on for months in order for us to reach a conclusion.
You sent a letter today to the Inspector General for the Department of State demanding an investigation of any State Department officials who work with Rudy Giuliani.
Correct.
Giuliani today, in an interview with The Atlantic, referred to himself as a hero, as a whistleblower as well. He also told CNN that he met with the State Department 10 times. Does it make any sense to you that the president's personal attorney would even be involved? I mean, if the cover story is we're concerned from as a nation about corruption in Ukraine, that it would be I would be on the, you know, the heavy weight of this would go on the slumped shoulders of Rudy Giuliani, when instead of like the Treasury Department, which has excellent people to investigate corruption, you know, there seems like there's a lot of levers the president could use.
Look, I think Rudy Giuliani really ought to stop talking and get a lawyer. Because, I mean, he is incriminating himself. The reality of it is that I am asking the Inspector General of the State Department to open an investigation to determine whether officials at the State Department facilitated Rudy Giuliani as the president's personal lawyer, engaging in, frankly, official conversations with officials from Ukraine about these matters, including the potential investigation or prosecution of any cases. Because we need to know if the personal lawyer of the president, Giuliani, was using government resources for political gain. And frankly, if there were any members of the State Department who were facilitating Rudy Giuliani's private conversations on behalf of the president, there should be accountability and consequence for that. So I'm calling for the IG to investigate if any state officials worked with Giuliani to help him with his personal quest. But I am also saying, Anderson, that I actually also think that the State Bar of New York needs to investigate Rudy Giuliani.
You think he should lose his license?
Well, I think that there should be an investigation of whether he should actually retain a license and whether he's qualified to do that. And does he pass all of the requirements that we have for the ethical behavior of a lawyer?
You think he's violated basic ethics of an attorney?
I think that it's certainly a good question to ask, and that's why the bar should probably take a look at it and determine that. But there's so many incidents of his behavior that call into question his ability to actually follow ethical rules in terms of honesty.
You're calling on Attorney General Barr to recuse himself. I just want to play an exchange between you and Barr from a hearing in May, because it's taken on even greater weight right now. Let's listen.
Has the president or anyone at the White House ever asked or suggested that you open an investigation of anyone? Yes or no, please, sir.
The president or anybody else.
Seems you would remember something like that and be able to tell us.
Yeah, but I'm trying to grapple with the word suggest. I mean, there have been discussions of matters out there that they have not asked me to open an investigation, but
perhaps they've suggested.
I don't know. I wouldn't say suggest.
Hinted?
I don't know.
Inferred? You don't know. Okay.
Do you want to get him back in that seat to answer that under oath?
Yes, and that's what I'm calling for, that Attorney General Barr would come back before the United States Congress. We have a duty to conduct oversight, and including into whether the Attorney General of the United States has been requested by the President of the United States to engage in what would be unlawful conduct, which is to use the resources of the United States Department of Justice for the political gain of the President of the United States. So yes, I strongly believe that Attorney General Barr should come back before Congress and answer this question under oath. Because Anderson, you know, as you know, for a large part of my career, I was a prosecutor. I was the Attorney General of California for two terms, where I ran the second largest Department of Justice in the United States, second only to the United States Department of Justice. And there is so much about all of this that has been about really an attack on the integrity of our system of democracy, in particular our elections process, and our system of justice. And those people who are compromising the integrity of these systems, they must be held to account. Mm. So that's why I think he should come before us and he should tell us what's going on.
Senator Kamala Harris, I appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you.
Coming up next, our legal